Hey y'all, this recipe has some Asian-inspired flavors, and yes, it uses a little soy sauce. From a nutritional perspective, too much soy in the diet is not a good thing, and most of us are eating way more soy and soy-derived ingredients than we realize. I always recommend people removing soy from their diet in the beginning to see how your body feels without it, and because removing soy typically cuts out a whole lot of processed foods. But I also have not seen any compelling evidence to completely remove traditional soy-based foods from the diet wholesale. I have personally found that a little real soy sauce every now and then adds some flavor without causing any adverse health effects. Make sure you do use real soy sauce though. It will say tamari on it. Most soy sauce is actually derived from wheat, which is clearly not traditional soy sauce. And if you'd rather not use soy sauce at all, you can always substitute liquid aminos. Okay, now that that's out of the way, let's get cooking. Begin by heating the oven to 425 and line a baking sheet in foil. Cut the ends off the bok choy and slice them in half from root to stem. Place them cut side down on the baking sheet and drizzle with a little olive oil. Place in the oven and roast for 20 minutes. While the bok choy is roasting, heat some butter in a pan. Once the butter is hot, place the chicken drumsticks in the pan and season with salt and pepper. Cook the chicken for 8 to 12 minutes per side. You want to make sure that the chicken is fully cooked through, meaning that all of the juices run clear and it's white on the inside. While the chicken is cooking, mix the soy sauce or liquid aminos with your ginger, shallot, and garlic. You're gonna do that in a small saute pan over medium-low heat. Let everything heat up for about 5 minutes. Once the bok choy is done and the chicken is cooked to your liking, place them side by side on a plate and spoon some of the soy sauce mixture on top of the veggies. Let's eat.